Spooktober is a time for darker tales, betrayal, revenge, death. So this video, I want to share the story of Rego Draz, a Pentoshi who went from having everything to losing it in a very, very dark way. So as I said, Rego was born in Pentos, and unfortunately he was from a lower class, so he didn't have a lot of respect. Even when he built himself up from nothing and became the richest man in Pentos, the Pentoshi still didn't respect him. He was still from a lower class. He would never, ever be anything more in their eyes, no matter how much money he had. But that turned out not to matter all the way across the sea in the Seven Kingdoms. King Jaehaerys I Targaryen decided, hey, if this guy can come from a low birth and start with nothing and become the richest man in his city, surely he can help with the Iron Throne, which was having some issues with money and debt due to the previous king, King Maegor I, the Cruel, being a little bloodthirsty. So to that end, King Jaehaerys decided to invite Rego to the Seven Kingdoms to become the Master of Coin, which he eagerly agreed to because he wanted to get out of Pentos and become something more. When he went to King's Landing, he was given the title of Lord, though it's more Lord of Air because he didn't have any soldiers, he didn't have any land, he didn't have a castle or anything like that. Rego soon grew not only in wealth, but also in size. Over a decade of being a beautiful master of coins, helping raise the economy of the Seven Kingdoms and get the crown out of debt, he had many excesses, which helped him grow. To the point where he was so fat he could no longer be on a horse, he had to be carried around. And since he was being carried around, he might as well do it in style. So he had an ornate, decorated palanquin, which was carried from his home to the castle and back whenever he needed. And you may be wondering, okay, why wasn't he living in the Red Keep if he was a master of coin? Well, the king had offered many times, hey, take up residence here, but he wanted to stay in the Street of Silks where he could visit concubines, where he could be pleasured without those in the Red Keep clutching their pearls and going, oh my gosh, prostitutes. But that turned out to be a mistake, something that Rego learned way, way too late. In 59 AC, a terrible plague ended up hitting King's Landing called the Shivers. Typically, from the first time you shiver, and within 24 hours, you're dead. And it ran rampant through King's Landing, even taking the captain of the city guard. Now, you can imagine, okay, captain is suddenly gone, their commander is not there to keep them together. The city watch was in disarray. There was chaos everywhere, and no longer could they keep order. Women were raped, men were robbed, shops were just looted nonstop. You could be murdered just for walking, standing, looking at someone. It was crazy. King Jaehaerys tried to bring order by sending men down, but it wasn't happening. It was too much chaos. On Rego's last day alive, during this chaos, he took the wrong route to the Red Keep. He decided to go through Flea Bottom, which is the worst place you can go through in King's Landing on a normal, regular basis, but especially with chaos being throughout the city and with the Shivers taking people out, it was a really bad decision. He eventually was spotted by a dozen Flea Bottom residents who were chasing a piglet. They were drunk, they were starving. They saw this man on this ornate thing being carried, how big he was, and they thought, he is the reason for the high cost of bread. He is the reason why we are starving, and they decided to attack him and his men. Rego tried to scream for them to stop, but he screamed in his native tongue, and none of them could understand him. He raised his hands to defend himself against the blows of the small folk, but when they saw all his glittering rings, it just enraged them even more. A woman ended up shouting he's Pentoshi and that they were the ones that brought the Shivers over. And in response, another small folk ended up prying up a stone from the newly cobbled street, a street that Rego himself had made sure was beautifully done, and they bashed his head in over and over and over again, to the point where the only thing that you could see was a red mush of brains and bones and fragments of his skin. But before the attackers ran away, they ended up stripping him of all his valuables, cutting off his fingers, taking his rings, and getting out of there. He went from nothing to becoming the master of coins and helping the economy and helping the very people that ended up bashing his brains in. The men responsible were eventually found by King Jaehaerys I, at his orders, and they were hung like a beautiful tapestry with their entrails hanging out. And he made sure that they were alive when they were strung up, and then their entrails spilling out, so they died in twisting agony. And that is the tragic tale of Rego Drazz. Thank you so much for watching. Like, subscribe, and come back for more videos.